Then now this was the distance matrix meter S1, S2, S3. Now this was alignment you got. You then calculated the distances. These are the distances. Actually, whole thing depends on this distance calculation. This is the important one. You everybody got the distance matrix, whether you worked with the UPGMA or neighborhood joining. In that, you used F84, then Kimura, Jukes-Kantor, and Log-Date. That are the methods, the distance matrix methods available in Philip. But in case of past, you have number of dissimilarity and similarity coefficient matrices you can calculate. Okay, Jacquard's is the, for similarity you are working, then Jacquard coefficient, that's one. And Euclidean, if you are not getting any data, if you have frequency data, better way use a Euclidean distance. That is the best method. Okay, everybody, means most of the medical science have seen Euclidean distance, that is the main, or Manhattan. Okay, that's the another, or Kimura model, they go for. But if Jukes-Kantor, there are means some methods, they are feasible or they are suitable for particular sequence data types. Okay, because they have some evolutionary model that is designed. So, their calculation is complicated. Okay, so better Jacquard's is also very easy, simple method of matrix generation, this matrix. So, always try which method I should use. Now, I will tell you how you can save the file in PASTA in Nexus format, and then you can convert it into Philip format, or which can be visualized in Mega. That I will tell you. Okay. Even you can bootstrap the file, you know that PASTA. Okay. So, that's our today's point. But better use the software, this one, Philip. Why? Because Philip is command line, you are directly interacting with the programs. Okay, that's directly interacting with the input file. But when you worked with the PASTA, there is an interface. Means interface is there, then the program is working or running behind that interface. Means in between the user and the program, the interface is there. So sometimes what happens if you work fastly, because graphical, you just need to click on it. But you are working on a Philip, you need to write a command. So it takes, means computer also get the time to think and to process. But when you are working with a PASTA, what happens? You click on the just radiation button is the given, but you never allow the computer to calculate that things. So what happens? The computer get hanged or destabilized. So the better way, that's a problem with the PASTA. Otherwise, that is also good program. Means some good programs are there with it. Okay. So this is the main how you are calculating, means which method is you are using for calculating the distances, and that is the important one. Other than another one is the inferred tree. Two methods are there. Either you can work with the neighborhood joining or you can go for a UPGMA. Okay, both the methods are suitable. I have just taken some trees yesterday. I've tried and I will show you some differences what the result you got. So this was the okay main distances. Okay, how the branch length is optimized. Okay, each branch length, that is mainly based on a distance method. Then this was the methods and program summary. Nucleotide and protein sequences, distance method, either neighborhood joining or UPGMA. What you have to do first, use for replication what seek boot. That was the means. Bootstrap, there are three methods, bootstrap, jackknife or permutation combination. You can use three methods or better, bootstrap is the widely used method for recombination, okay, or data replication. So minimum for nucleotide sequences or protein as alphabet. For protein you can take more than that because there are alphabets are more. In case of nucleotide sequence only four alphabets are there. So you can 1000 is the minimum requirement of data replication, 1000. You can go for 5000 also if you want. Okay, so then next is, if it's a nucleotide sequence, use the DNA distance, or if it's a protein, then use the prot distance. What it do? Calculate the distance matrix for 1000 replicates. Don't forget to tell the distance, DNA distance or prot distance, that the data set is replicates. If you don't use the options multiple data sets, what it will do? It will just select first set and draw the tree. Same is the case. Then drawing the tree, this is the distance calculation, then drawing the tree, neighbor. In this also, you have to tell the program that the multiple data set is used. But remember that How many replicates are there? If your replicates are 1000 and don't tell the program that you have the replicates 5000, so it will be a problem. So you can use, okay, 1000, but you can use the 100 lesser than the value. Then next is consensus. Consensus tree is not a average tree, but it's a tree that what are the conserved patterns in the tree. Means you have the 1000 tree, out of 1000 tree, the maximum number of trees that are showing consensus pattern, like conserved region, we have seen a multiple sequence alignment. In the same case, if you have 1000 tree, in that 1000 tree, particular branch length or that root nodes, they are conserved in more than 50 or maximum number of trees over there in available all the tree. So that will be selected. That is called as, that's why it is called as consensus tree. Okay. And accordingly, based on that data, ki kitne hai usme conserved, matlab kitne trees mein ya dendrograms mein wo conserved region hai, ya conserved node hai, ya that conserved pattern hai. Okay, bifurcation ka. So that will be taken. Then next, isi tarah se it will go on. Okay, so that is consensus. Same maximum likelihood method. What do you do? Sequence boot, but minimum should be what? 1000. Okay, for protein you can go for a 2000, but keep patience, let the computer do analysis, don't enter or close the program. So that's the problem. Then DNML, you can use the DML for DNA sequences, nucleotide, and ProML for protein sequences, and again consensus sequence. So first day you not use this sequence boot or consensus, okay, but yesterday you have gone through all the process, what is the actual. But before doing working with the replication data, take out the tree without using the sequence boot and consensus tree. Okay, you work with these two softwares and then get the tree, and then also generate the tree by using the replication data or bootstrap method. Then maximum parsimony method, sequence boot, DNA parse or pro parse and consensus. So this is for distance method, this is for maximum likelihood method, and this is for parsimony method. Okay. So it will for nucleotide or protein sequences. Then methods and program summary, RFLP, RAPD or ARDRA data or AFLP data also. Okay. Now if it's RAPD data, okay, RAPD, that's a primary you are taking, so you have to mention that's okay, the length forward and the reverse primer. So the length is 10 plus 10, 20. But if it's RFLP, then the restriction side is either 4 or 6. 6 is the default. Means depends on whether it's a hexacutter or tetracutter. That you have to mention. But in case of the RFLP, the input file. Okay, this is input file. 12 is the number of tags. Actually, some have skipped. Then 5 is the number of characters. One more thing will be added. That is the number of enzymes that are used. Restriction for RFLP. Okay. But for ARDRA, you no need to, okay, you can consider RAPD, ARDRA and AFLP as a similar. In case of AFLP, the band, the primer size, means the site, restriction site or that cutting site, you can consider as a length of 16 residue. Okay, so what was the problem while working with this file? Maximum, ML matter, rest ML, okay. It was the problem, you have to fool the software that, though you are using the RAPD data, but you can tell that so okay, you are using the RFLP data. Just add 2 here. You are using 2 primers. So just add 2 over here. It will work on. That file will. And it will generate the dendrogram. But that data, that tree is not reliable. Okay. Means what you are using. Means for RAPD, the RestML is not the method for RAPD. Yeah? It's only for RFLP. Okay. So what you have to do? You have to place 2 here. Why 2? You are using a 2 means forward and reverse primers for that, and you can calculate. So same way it will generate the, this is the file I generated yesterday by using the rust ML method. Okay.